Hi everyone, welcome back to Chop's Garage. It's time to play our favourite game again. Why was the car really part exchanged? So we've just picked up this Citroen DS4. So we'll get it off the trailer and we'll have a good look around it. This is a 2012 62 plate. It's done 130,000 miles on, but it had its cam belt done last month. And I did check, this is the same engine as the Picasso I did. I did check for oil leaks and no oil leak on this one. Well, nothing serious anyway. Looks like it's fairly tidy overall. There's a small few bits and bobs, but what I say, we'll get it off the trailer and have a good look at it. But this is going to be a cheap car. I don't think this is going to be more than 3495. And when we start looking through the spec of it, I think you'll be quite impressed because this is the DS4, not the C4. So it's the fancy one, isn't it? Now, the first thing we're going to do with the little C4 is hop on and do a quick check. Check the history of the car. Make sure there's no outstanding finance. Make sure the mileage looks like it ties up. All that kind of good stuff. And obviously for that, we're going to use today's sponsor, Car Vertical. So we pop the reg into Car Vertical there. We can see that the mileage ties up. No notification for theft. No notification of accidents, ideal, no outstanding finance. Just going through some spotted activity here. This is quite a good one for checking what's happened on the MOTs. So 2016, a lot about brake pads and discs. 2017, still got bad discs. 2017, still got bad discs. They must have got the discs sorted because in 2018, it just needed tyres. Change of ownership 2020, so the last owner's had it for a couple of years by the looks of it, but we're back to having bad discs again. So when we test drive it, we want to be seeing how those brake discs work out. Nothing major, they're just headlight adjustment. So again, nothing regarding driving school, police vehicle, hit being scrapped, anything like that. Stolen vehicle check across Europe's come back okay. Mileage, I like this graph, it gives us an idea of how the car was used. So we can see that there was a discrepancy here, but it isn't flagging a problem overall because it looks like it was just a one-off entry mistake. But this car has been doing a good number of miles per year. It's been consistently used, which is a good sign for me because you can't do that kind of mileage unless you are looking after the car. So overall, yeah, nothing regarding damage at all. It's looking like a nice straight car. So valuation, it's saying when the seller is a company, the retail value is 3370. So 3495, I don't think I'm out of order asking that, looking at it. Now our DS4 had a good history, but it doesn't mean every car. We'll take this Fiat 500X, for example. Mileage okay, no theft, but recorded as having accident damage. Now scrolling down, Car Vertical goes a step further and actually shows us pictures of the vehicle at the salvage auction with the damage. So you can see exactly how much damage it had. And then subsequent photos of the car up for sale after repair. And you can see here, you'd have no idea that vehicle had that damage unless you had a Car Vertical report. The great news is, if you want to do your own Car Vertical on a vehicle you've already got or one you're looking to buy, if you look in the link in the description down below, you'll get a discount code off your first check. I'd like to thank Car Vertical for being a continued sponsor of Chop's Garage. Haven't driven the car. We'll go for a test drive together on that and find out for ourselves. This was a Part X, another dealership. I was told it drives okay, so we'll find out as we go around it. It was really hard to value it because I couldn't find any other DS4s on a 2012 on Auto Trader. Not this age, they're all a much newer. So I don't know what that's all about. I had to value it the same as a DS4, but when you start looking around this car, value it the same as a C4. When you start going around the car, you realize there's a big difference between the vehicles in terms of spec wise. This is a really nice looking motor. So we've got, obviously everything's color coded. It's a bit dirty, it needs a good clean. We've got the lower spotlights. We've got the diamond cut alloy wheels, Continental tire on the front there. Color-coded wing mirrors, we've got all the chrome finishes down the side and all the DS logos on it. Diamond cut alloy at the back's got some lacquer peel on it. I don't think, we're going to talk about price point on this, but I don't think it's the kind of thing I'd do on a car this price point. That's a Taurus rear tire on the back there. Now that's got, the front one was pretty much new. So this front tire's new, and that's Continental. The rear tire is nearly new. That isn't very old, and that's Taurus. So I think I'd rather have the Continentals on the front anyway. We've got rear parking sensors. We've got a chrome finisher on the back there. The little crack in the chrome finisher, again, something on this age I wouldn't do. It's quite free of dings and dents. We've got a little scratch there that will polish out. And I haven't really spotted anything else as I've gone round. Got a little bit chipping down the edge of the door there, but that's easily touched in. I think with a clean and a machine polish, this will be really nice. We've got rear tinted glass. The alloy here again has got the old lacquer peel from diamond cut alloys. It's the bane of my life, that. And the front one's got not as bad. Interesting, the two front aren't as bad as the two rear for some reason. Again, on there, what have we got? We've got Continental, so it's matching tyres on each axle. So, not too bad at all. Customer who got this got a brand new car, so they weren't short of a bob or two. Now inside, it shocked me how sporty the seats are. So these look like they're a half leather. Again, they could do with a bit of a wet clean. They're not bad at all. I mean, the bolsters are wearing really well, considering how high they are. You'd think they would wear right through. The seats are electric and heated. So like I say, big difference between this and a C4. We've got DS little door trims there, electric mirrors, electric windows with folder on the mirrors as well. Inside we've got cruise control, Bluetooth, stereo controls. We've got auxiliary input down here, air conditioning. We've got front and rear heated screens. Can I see it in there? And this is all in really good nick. This is all going to come up really nicely. Gear knobs worn. Can't really see that, but that might be... Yeah, that's worn for a little bit. You can't really see the stuff on that. So that's the only real sign of wear inside is the gear knob itself. If we look in the back, we've got that half leather trim carrying on. These look in really good condition. This is actually really clean car inside. Really clean car. It's not going to need an awful lot. So these front two seats, maybe a little bit wet clean on these lighter areas of the bolster. Steering wheel's in good nick. There isn't too much wear there. It's got a nice flat edge on it. So a quick look in the boot. That's clean as well. That's only going to need a little hoover out. It's a good sized boot. It's just going to need a little hoover out. What have we got in here? Some kind of compressor kit for your spare tyre. Almost seems like there should have been a bit of card or something underneath that to stop that from sagging down. Not sure. This is something I hadn't spotted before on these. So this windscreen, these windscreen bits here, you can actually push them back to give yourself more glass at the front if you want. Because that's too much for you, the sun's too much. You just slide them forward. It's pretty cool, isn't it? Right, so let's get the key a sec. So start it up. Starts on the button. 131,000 miles, which I guess you could consider high, but at this age, coming on 13 years old, just telling me your fuel level's low. 13 years old, 10,000 miles a year is the average now, so it's not really that high. No warning lights at all on the dash other than low fuel, so that's a good sign. I think we have got a bit of paperwork service history wise, let's have a quick look at that. It's a strange one, the service history starts at 2016, 17, 18, 19, and that was a cam belt service 2019. And that started at 62,000 miles. So I wonder if the person that bought this car, they're both main dealer. That's main dealer. So yeah, I wonder if the person that bought the car started recording. Mind you, they're all at the same dealership. And then that one's an independent. I guess we'll never really know. But that's strange, it starts 2016. Unless it was one of those all-inclusive packages where they got servicing with it and they didn't stamp the book. I guess we could check with Citroen C. Got a load of receipts in there, so we've got a look at those. So we've got tyres from 6 months ago. So the fuse box to resolve an ECU problem at, or sorry, not an ECU problem. So the fuse box to repair a daytime running light problem. So that's cool. So the new battery in 2020. Been down to Barry Hughes. We all know Barry. Well, if you live down this way, you do. It's had a parking brake switch on it. So that would have been for the electronic handbrake it's got there. So that's cool. They're always going to go at some point or another, aren't they? Oh, there's a receipt from Bazza for the fuse box. So Barry Hughes has done the fuse box on it. And he's done some track rod ends there in 2021. Now, it won't mean a lot to you guys, but Barry Hughes is well respected locally. And he's not the cheapest of the mechanics locally, but he's one of the best. So whoever had this car was getting it looked after. And the service history has happened most recently. So that's not bad at all. If we look at it, I think we can tell when the next service is due. Let's have a quick look. If we press that button there. That's a reset. Right, so it's saying 10,000 miles for the service there. So it must have been serviced and reset locally. So recently, there must be more services after that 2019 one. And I can't imagine a person spending the money getting all the other stuff done and wasn't getting it serviced. So again, probably not stamped. And when was the cam belt done? How many miles is the cam belt done at? I didn't know how many miles it was done at. It was done at 103,000 miles. So 103,000 miles, and it was done, was that 3 years ago? So should be another 2 or 3 years before it needs another cam belt, I'd have thought, unless someone does mega miles on it. So overall, it's in good nick. I don't think it's going to need an awful lot to clean it up. I don't think it needs any paint at all, actually. I think after a wash and a polish, this is going to be a really good looking car. And that interior is really nice. And that's going to come up clean up. The front here, passenger seat's heated and electric as well. Now this is the 1.6 HDI style, I think it is. I think because it's the higher spec one, it puts up to 135 road tax. I think the C4 is a 30 road tax, so slightly higher road tax, but a much better looking car in my opinion. And I think the manufacturers say like 60 miles to the gallon average, but I think owners say 50 miles to the gallon average is more realistic. So last thing to do is, well, should have been the first thing to do, I guess, is take it for a test drive and see if we think there's some ominous reason it was part exchanged in the first place. So out in the DS4, we'll go through the gears, check they all smoothly engage, which they are so far, up into sixth, no resistance in any of the gears, so you're looking to see if it needs to be forced a little bit to go into a gear. Accelerate when you're in the gears, just see if anyone want to pop out or not. No, it's all good. We're looking for the suspension, so we will purposely look for manhole covers and so forth and see if we get any knocks and bangs from the suspension. A lot of you guys ask me what to look for on cars, so this is kind of why I'm elaborating a little bit more. And so here we go, we've got a couple of manhole covers here, run over those. No knocking or banging, so the suspension seems good. We'll try from the other side. Yeah, that's all good. And bear in mind, we've got fairly low profile tyres. I don't know what this person's doing. We've got fairly low profile tyres, so it really is, it's actually riding really quite well. We'll listen to the engine, seeing if there's any sort of tappetiness to it. If it makes any strange noises. Now, obviously, diesels are a bit noisier anyway. I've driven a few of these, so I kind of know what to expect, but the engine itself, nothing sounds strange at all on that. We've hit some bad potholes there again. No knocks and bangs, so I think like springs, track rod ends, all that seems to be good. We let go of the steering wheel briefly, and it's not pulling to one side or the other. So we haven't got any tracking issues. Just have the issue of someone driving incredibly slowly in front. So that's all good. Engine wise, we're looking for something in this 1.6 diesel. It'll never set the world like power wise, but we just want to see if it's got a bit of mid-range punch, which it has. Smoothly accelerates. Being a turbo, we're listening for whether there's any whistles from the engine bay. Also, we want to give it a good amount of boost, because if there's any pinholes in any of the piping on the car for the turbo, or if the vanes of the turbo are sticky, when we give it full boost, it will throw up an engine code because the boost reading won't be right. So we'll let this car get a little bit further ahead, but we'll give it a full boost to make sure that's okay. But I have to say, so far, it's smooth. It's really smooth. The gearbox is nice. There's no notchiness in the clutch at all. That's coming up down smoothly enough. The brakes are brutal. The brakes are bang on. It must have had some disc and pads recently, I would have thought, because the brakes are brilliant. There's no excessive wind noise from bad rubbers, so if you're getting a lot of wind noise coming in, it could be that you've got torn up rubbers on the doors. That seems good. We'll give it a quick boost now. This person really is driving slowly in front though, so it's hard to. Yep. Seems happy enough for that. Doesn't have any problems. There's not a big kick of boost on these. It's down about 1500 revs. You get a bit of a slab of torque there. No point holding the gears for very long because all the torque is low down. So obviously this is the point where we're looking to try and find out, why was the car part exchanged? Was it part exchanged for mechanical problems? Now this car has an MOT that's due next month. I almost like that because it's a kind of an indicator they just didn't want to spend money on the next MOT before they changed their car. If a car's just had an MOT and they sell it, I don't know, when you see that at auction a lot of time, that's a little bit suspicious. But the story I've had on this car is that the young lady's been looking to get a new car from the dealership for a long time, has been umming and ahhing about whether to do it, but just got a promotion and got higher pay, so having looked at cars for a number of months, that gave her the trigger to come in and get a new car. And obviously, you know, when a car starts getting up to 130,000 miles, most people will consider changing in. So I'm pretty happy the story seems genuine. I couldn't find anything in all those invoices. That's the reason you want to go through the invoices in real detail and see if there's been any quotes or diagnosis of problems that haven't been resolved. So yeah, I've got to say, it drives absolutely lovely. And as far as it is so far, I don't seem to have noted any real problems. So the next thing is to get it up to temp. So we'll drive a little bit longer. You don't need to see all of that. We'll drive for longer. We want to get it up to fully up to temperature and start to see if there's any overheating problems. A lot of problems can be hidden on the car until it gets fully up to temperature. Gosh, this person's slow. 30 miles an hour all the way. So guys, pleasantly surprised with that so far. Only fault I've found with it so far is rear parking sensors don't seem to be working. No warning on the dash. I'm not quite sure whether they've, or what the score is with that. We've got a little ding in the door over here I've noticed as I've parked it up, but that's very minor. Overall, really nice condition and a beautiful drive. I'm really quite impressed with that. It's got a really nice ride because the tyres aren't too crazy low profile. The diesel's got a nice little bit of punch to it. And it's really quite refined when you're inside. So yeah, I'm happy with that. Money wise, this car is probably going to go up for $3,495. I haven't even checked what Autotrader says it's worth yet. I imagine it's going to say it's worth a bit more than that. But I think $3,495 is a cracking price point for it. I think it'll fly out the door at that money. We'll stick a new MOT on it. It's got to go down for a new MOT. We're doing an oil and filter service on it because we don't really know what's happened with the history after that cam belt side of things. So do an oil and filter, do a new MOT on it, stick it out the door with a warranty on it, probably 3 months, 3.5. So I've taken a few quick photos of the DS and got it up on the website. I put it up for the 3.5. It's a bit of a chance because it's got to now go down for MOT, and that's going to be the real test as to whether this car was sold or part exchanged prior to MOT for a reason that the seller knew. We obviously haven't been underneath it. Like I said, it didn't have any major knocks and bangs, seemed to drive okay, but we don't know what emissions are like. We don't know what the bottom half of the engine looks like. We don't know what the underside is like overall in terms of the rest of the discs and the pads, the springs, the shocks, all that kind of stuff. So we could still be in for some big bills. You know, you can have, on these modern cars, you can have daft stuff like some of the lighting doesn't work and turns out to be like, you know, hundreds of pounds per headlamps type of thing. So it is a bit of a risk. So good news on the C4, passed MOT, it passed MOT. They left the two advisories. One was that it needs a number plate bulb on the back, and the second was simply that the emissions were that clean they couldn't be read. So all good on that front. We did really well there. Shame to have any advisories on the MOT at all. Normally they'd just swap the bulb out, but they thought I wanted the car straight back, so they didn't do that. So I will do the number plate bulb. It needs another valet, obviously, but that's a bit of a result. I've also spent another day driving the car, and I have to say, I've driven, you know, obviously the Astra 1.6 diesels, the Focus 1.6 diesels. Now the Focus is my favourite, but I'd have this over an Astra all day long. And to be honest, if you're not a big driver, then probably the DS4 over the Focus as well. Yeah, the Focus handles a little bit better and has a little bit more punch, but it's marginal. I mean, it's less than 10%, I'd say. And yeah, again, versus an Astra, I would have this over it all day long. Plus, obviously, this is cheaper than a Focus and cheaper than an Astra, I'd have thought. And just the spec is really nice. I learned something as well, is what I mistook as, I'm sure some people have been in the comments already saying this, as a heated seat, is actually a massage seat. You hit that button there. So this does your lumbar in and out, but that actually sets the lumbar on like a rotation. The pad comes in and out, which I found out on nicely enough on the way back from the gym in the morning. So that's a nice little bonus. It just drives really, really nice. I haven't found any other faults, I say, other than the rear parking sensors not working. I'm not going to faff around with that because it's going to be a cheap car. Like I say, we're going to stick up at 3495, see how we get on with that. And I think for a 2012 car with a new MOT on it, we'll put a 6 month warranty on it. Yeah, I think, and this kind of spec, I think it's a cracking little buy. So that's a bit of a result. Happy with that one. Doesn't always work out that way. Those of you that know Chops Garage will know it doesn't always work out that way. And obviously, we still have the warranty period to see how we get on with the car. There could be claims for other problems that come to light. But like I say, after 2 days worth of driving, I've not found anything. So yeah, if you enjoyed that and you like to see cars flipped, and like I say, you like to see when it doesn't necessarily always go that smoothly, do consider hitting that subscribe button down below, which will give you notifications when the new videos come out. Won't cost you anything, just give you notifications when the new videos come out. And as always, massive thanks for watching, everyone. See you again soon.